difference between maybe the first generation learning technologies, which is really focused on compliance. Everything they're actually going to do after that is built upon that, they built that on that concept. If we think about an organization, what's really going to allow an organization to perform, it is the knowledge that exists in the people's heads. The focus of an NGLE, such as Fuse, is how do you get the knowledge out of people's heads, the knowledge they've had and the knowledge they're consistently going to create, and how do you get that out into formats that people love to use? So the formats that we love to use in our personal lives, in our consumer lives. So NGLEs are really uber focused on the operational piece, the piece that's in the workflow. Well, when I don't know how to do my job, this is where I go, and I find the answer and I consume it within 60 seconds. So you think about that, that's really talking about content and search, much more so than it's thinking about kind of, you know, your traditional mandatory compliance learning. Concepts and procedures are put into either structures, learning plans, pathways, are popped up through discovery, understanding who wants to see what. But then critically in the workplace, then allowing the person to search and say, I don't know how to do the process. The NGLE is an enabler of that workplace learning piece, the piece where the best knowledge from the organization is curated, created, built from ground up and from top down to give this amazing experience, which this marriage of content you love and technology that's frictionless and consumer grade. Spending on average 225 minutes a day on the mobile devices, accessing information, knowledge, communication, and so forth. That's the future battlefield for learning. So if we're really going to nail that, right, and if we really want to understand that learning is no longer just about putting people into a course, and it's no longer just about having an online course, it's how do we get people's attention in those moments? And those moments is when I'm in my job and I don't know how to do something, when I'm on the train home, and I want to discover and I've got 5 minutes, I want to do it. How are we competing for those attention, those 225 minutes? It's the same way I'd browse YouTube in the evening, because there's stuff that's popping up that I'm finding interesting in, because it's my job, it's my hobby, it's my role. How do you industrialize the process of taking the knowledge out of people's brains and into the brains of others in a really quick, fast way? How do you move past things like SCORM and content strategies and lengthy production processes, so actually content is created in a much more YouTube-style way? So it may be a learning professional with a new skill set, like a videographer like you're doing right now, interviewing the person and extracting out a great piece of knowledge, cutting and producing it, making it, you know, slightly more interesting and entertaining, and then allowing that to be accessed forever, however many times that person wants to access it or wants to show it and share it with other people. So when I hear people talking about, you know, is the organization ready? I know what they really mean. Am I ready for change? It's about the people in L&D and their mindset, not the organizations. The organization there has been brought there already by YouTube, Facebook, Twitter, and the rest of them. Is an organization ready to create that content? So I think the honest answer is they need help. I don't think any organization is ready to start digitizing the brains of their people using the old techniques to do so. If you're going to be ready for a next generation learning system, then actually we have to partner with you and we have to give you those new skills. From, you know, traditional kind of first generation learning organization that's classroom based and maybe kind of school-based learning based, into something that's much closer to a digital agency, with video storing techniques and journalistic techniques and visualizers, community managers and so forth. But that skill set is absolutely critical. We're not trying to be an HR company. We're not a talent management company. We're not trying to replace a workday or any cornerstone HR system. We're absolutely uber focused on being the company that drives performance through learning, knowledge and information. That's a very different perspective that we're trying to create and our innovation roadmap on. So everything in our roadmap is really thinking about how do you drive that performance goal? How do you make it even easier for that end person to get access to the knowledge they need, to the person they need, to the answer they need? So when we think about experience, we're not just thinking about how do you create a bunch of courses from a library? That's a lazy answer to the problem. The great answer to the problem is, how do I extract out that amazing knowledge in the heads of the people and give it in a format they love, that they're choosing and want to consume every day? It's been a magnificent journey, especially over the last 12 months. You know, we've grown 130% a year. We now have offices in London, Cape Town, Sydney. We have people in Madrid and in Canada, and we're adding more people and offices, you know, as we grow. So it's been a phenomenal journey and amazing that clients now trust us, not just, you know, for the organization with 20, 30,000 people, but now the first few Fortune 1000 companies rolling us out. I think the key now to growth and sustaining that growth is culture. Fuse is, at its heart, a technology that is about openness, transparency. That's a core value for us. Therefore, when recruiting people in, you want to attract people with those common values and common beliefs. So as long as we continue to attract people that are share those values of collaboration and openness and transparency across the world and share the belief in helping people to evolve their potential, I'm really, really confident that we're going to continue to have the same meteoric growth.